In this lecture video, we'll discuss boundary and initial condition. What are the different? Because in the previous lecture video, we have discussed the different modes of heat transfer. And heat transfer equation will get a differential equation. We'll get a differential equation for heat transfer. Maybe it is in this form, conduction equation. It is we'll get a differential equation. This is a conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate system. Here, first term, this term is diffusion term, this term is source, and this is steady state term. To get its algebraic equation, we need to solve this equation. We have to integrate it, and to get the values at a particular point, we need to apply boundary condition. Therefore, for a heat transfer, boundary conditions are important. And initial conditions means for solving the steady state term, we need initial conditions also. Prescribed temperature boundary condition. There are different types of boundary conditions. One condition is prescribed temperature boundary condition. It states, suppose if there is a slab, if there is a plate, prescribed temperature boundary condition says that at one side the temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. That we can call at x equal to 0, t is equal to 150 degrees Celsius. This is mentioning the temperature at a particular point. This type of boundary condition is called as prescribed temperature boundary condition. This is also called as Dirichlet boundary condition. This type of boundary condition is also called as Dirichlet boundary condition. Here, at one side the temperature is 150 degrees Celsius, at other side the temperature is 70 degrees Celsius. That is, at t x equal to 0, at time t temperature is equal to 150 degrees Celsius, at temperature t at x equal to L, time t temperature is equal to 70 degrees Celsius. This type of boundary condition is called as first kind of boundary condition. Now, the other kind of boundary condition is prescribed heat flux boundary condition. Means if we consider a thin layer here, as well as here, what will happen is in the thin layer, the heat will not be stored. Whatever the heat that is, suppose inside there is here on this part there is fluid, this is a solid, whatever the fluid is there here, heat transfer takes place from fluid to solid by convection. Whatever that heat transfer takes place, that will be conducted. Therefore, prescribed boundary condition can be second type of boundary condition is heat flux that enters is equal to heat flux that leaves. That we can give like this: whatever the heat convected, that is conducted. Heat again here also heat what is conducted here on this side, it is convected. Heat flux that is convected means we can write whatever the heat that is conducted means HA. This type of boundary condition is also called as Neyman boundary condition. Here, this type of boundary condition means whatever the heat flux that is entering at this point, it is Q is equal to heat that is conducted minus K dou T by dou X. If we mention heat flux, that type of boundary condition is called as Neumann boundary condition or second kind. If we mention direct temperature, that is first kind. If we mention heat flux, that is second kind. First kind is mentioning the temperature, that is first kind. Second kind is mentioning the heat flux. Heat flux means heat transfer per unit area. Heat transfer per unit area, that is heat flux. That can be given as dou T by dou X. Dou T by dou X. This is one kind of boundary condition. Heat flux is nothing but heat transfer per unit area, that is Q, capital Q divided by area is equal to heat flux, that is small q, heat flux Q. We'll discuss third kind of boundary condition is whatever the heat that is convected. First kind is temperature, mentioning the temperature. What is the temperature at that point? T is equal to 15 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Celsius, that is first kind. Second kind is mentioning the heat flux. Mentioning the heat flux is second kind. Third kind of boundary condition is whatever the heat that is convected, means heat, is suppose there is a fluid here inside. If there is a fluid here inside, if there is a fluid here, if the heat is, and here this is a solid, whatever the heat that is convected, it is equal to conducted, that is given here. Heat conducted, heat conducted is given by this term. At x equal to 0, heat conducted is minus k dou t by dou x 0 comma t. Heat convected here will be equal to, means a small thin layer is considered, whatever the heat that is convected here, it is equal to conducted. That type of boundary condition is known as third kind of boundary condition. It is nothing but one type of boundary condition where heat convected is equal to heat conducted. Interface boundary condition, actually this we have, if there are different materials, at the material we can see the interface boundary condition. At the material, at the interface of the material, whatever the heat that is conducted here, the same is conducted again. Ka for a material Ka dou T by dou X is equal to for a material Kb dou T by dou X. It is fourth kind, interface boundary condition. These are the different types of boundary condition, four type of boundary conditions. Now we'll discuss this. One dimensional steady state heat generation without heat generation, heat conduction without heat generation. One dimensional steady state, suppose if we consider a plane slab, if temperature here is T1, the temperature here is T2, heat transfer takes place in this direction, and T1 is the temperature, between the T1 and T2 the resistance is RL. If the length is L, resistance is RL. Resistance of the slab can be given by L divided by KA. Therefore, again using the Q is equal to KA divided by L. KA divided by L from Fourier law of conduction into T1 minus T2. T1 minus T2. T1 minus T2. Here this can be rearranged as KA divided by Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1 minus T2 divided by L by KA. Here L by KA is in the denominator of the denominator, therefore it comes in the numerator. These two equations are same. This equation is in the form of electrical analogy, where I is equal to phi by R. Phi is nothing but, therefore we can write this term is nothing but thermal resistance. Okay, this is a, in the last lecture video we have derived this equation in a three-dimensional conduction equation. This is one of the very important equation of heat transfer. the first term here. For the other conditions, the first term here I will repeat them. This is the diffusion term. The second term is the source term. This is a source term or generation term. This is a steady state term. If it is for a steady state, this term will be equal to zero. If there is no heat generation, this term will be equal to zero. If it is a one dimensional in x direction, these two terms will be equal to zero. And only this term will remain. For a steady state without heat generation in one dimension, only this term will remain. That is dou square t divided by dou x square is equal to zero. For steady state without heat generation, we can see here. Since if it is one dimension, then dou t by dou y, dou t by dou x equal to dou z is equal to zero, only dou t by dou x will be there. If we consider again, if it is a steady state, dou t by small dou t is equal to zero. If it is no internal heat generation, q gen is equal to zero. If it is isotropic material, then kx equal to ky is equal to kz. These are the assumptions which we have made. After those assumptions, we will get the equation for one dimensional steady state in x direction equation as dou square t divided by dou x square is equal to zero. If we, this is one of the differential equation. If we integrate it, we will get algebraic equation, and if we apply boundary condition, we will get algebraic equation, exact algebraic equation. If we integrate this equation twice, we will get like this integration of that 4.3. Integration of the 4.2 equation is 4.3. Okay, and applying the boundary condition, that is, if there is a slab at one side the temperature is T1 and on other side the temperature is T2, the length of the slab is L. On other side the temperature is T2. If A is the area, that is at x equal to 0, this is L. That is at x equal to 0, this is x direction. At x equal to 0, temperature is T1. At x equal to L, temperature is T2. If we apply these two boundary conditions in equation 4.3, that is above in this equation, if we apply x equal to 0, t is equal to T1, if we apply x equal to L, t is equal to T2 in this 4.3 equation, we will get this equation. We will get the equation 4.5. Okay, further applying the boundary condition, we will get Q is equal to, this is nothing but a Fourier law equation. Fourier law this is the equation for Cartesian coordinate. This is the equation in Cartesian coordinate. Again, this equation can be rewritten like this, and here this term L divided by Ka is the thermal resistance. And if it is a composite slab, means there are two or more slabs are there, one after the other. If it is a composite slab, then we can write, this is first composite slab of material 1, and if second composite slab, this one, this is the second composite slab, the third composite slab. If the internal temperature is TA and HA is the heat transfer coefficient at inside. If TB is the outside temperature and HB is the heat transfer coefficient outside, then we can see how the heat transfer will be. As here there is no heat storage, whatever the heat, only heat conduction is there. Whatever we have before, only we have assumed that there is no heat generation or heat storage, means there is no, it is a steady state. if there is heat storage, then there will be change in temperature. But here there is no change in temperature. Here on this side the temperature is TA. It is similar to furnace wall, made up of composite furnace wall. On one side, here, if Q is the heat transfer, it is made up of a composite furnace wall. Here, actually, convection heat transfer takes place because there will be fluid inside here there is a fluid, here there is a fluid, and here also there is a fluid. This is solid. This is first solid material, and second solid material, and third solid material. These three are solids. Okay, here for the first kind, here there is a conduction, here there is convection from TA to 1. Here the convection heat transfer takes place, that is from the fluid inside the to the wall surface of T1, and again from T1 to T2 there is conduction. Initially from TA to T1 there is convection, from T1 to T2 there is conduction. Further, from T2 to T3 there is conduction, and again from T3 to T4 there is conduction, but again from T4 to TB, here T4 to TB, this is again convection heat transfer. We will write electrical analogy for this, that is I is equal to V divided by R. We can assume like that. In the similar way, Q is equal to. These are like resistances in series. Delta T, Q is equal to delta T divided by summation of R. Here summation of R is R nothing but RA plus R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus RB. Okay, we'll discuss. RA is the thermal resistance due to convection heat transfer. Therefore, it will be 1 divided by HA. RA will be equal, we'll discuss one by one here. RA will be equal to, RA will be equal to, this is RA. RA is equal to 1 divided by HA into AA. It is a convection heat transfer. R1 is equal to L1 divided by K1A1. R1. R2 is equal to L2 divided by K2A2. R3 is equal to L3 divided by K3A3. RB is again convection heat transfer. Therefore, it is equal to 1 divided by HB into A. If we add this, we will get summation of T, summation of R resistances. Okay, here important thing is, this is summation of R. All the summation of R is nothing but RA plus R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus RB. If we take Q, okay, it is equal to, if we take these two temperature T1 and T2, if we take here T1 and T2 here, for this equation we have taken summation of R as for this equation we have taken summation of R as RA R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus RB. Therefore, we have to take the temperature from this TA to TB. Therefore, it will be TA minus TB divided by summation of R. But if we take only the temperature like this, T1 minus T2, if we take only the temperature T1 minus T2, we have to take the resistance in between those temperatures. Resistance in between the temperature T1 minus T2 is nothing but R1. R1 is the resistance from the temperature T1 and T2, that is R1. and if we take a temperatures like this, these two are same, this Q and this Q both are same, these two Q's are same, whatever the Q here and the Q here, they are same. This is electrical logging, means if heat electric current is flowing inside a series of electrical resistance, current remains same. In the similar way, if heat is transferring inside through the slab, then heat current will remain same. If we take the temperature Q again, if we take the temperature T1 and T4, T1 minus T2, T1 minus T4. This important thing here is we have to consider the resistance in between T1 and T4. What are the resistance in between T1 and T4? The resistance in between T1 and T4 are R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Therefore, whatever the temperatures we have to take the resistance in between those, whatever the number of resistance that are there in between those, okay, R3, we have to take these resistances. Suppose if we are taken T1 minus T3, we have to take here in the denominator R1 plus R2. Here all these Q's are same, all these heat transfers are same. The same thing has been derived here, okay. If heat transfer is like this, when the resistance, if heat is transferring, if the materials, this top surface is made up of one material and bottom is of made up of another material, we can call it as a resistance in parallel. It will be like this, resistance in parallel. Again the same concept, Q is equal to delta T, that is T1 minus T2 divided by R. T1 minus T2 divided by R. R is nothing but here, it is not equal to R1 plus R2, because here the resistance are in parallel. We can, from physics, we can see that resistance for electrical current, here R is called as R equivalent. R is not equal to R1 plus R2. I will tell what is R should be equal to. R equivalent. That R equivalent can be written as this R equivalent. It is nothing but 1 divided by R1. 1 divided by R equivalent is equal to 1 divided by R equivalent equal to 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2. It is similar to the electrical analogy. 1 divided by R2. Here R1 and R2 are again L1 divided by K1 A1. Here from this equation, these are the resistances in parallel. If the condition is like this, here we can see the resistance in series as well as in parallel are there. For this one, resistance in series as well as in parallel. Here 1 and summation of 2, 3 and 4 are in series. 1 and some R equivalent of these three are in, sorry, 1 and R equivalent of these three are in series, but R2, R3 and R4 are in parallel. Therefore R effective for R2, R3 and R4 is calculated like this. R effective for R2, R3 and R4 is calculated as 1 divided by R2 plus 1 divided by R3 plus 1 divided by R4. That is R equivalent. R equivalent is equal to. Now the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient. Overall heat transfer coefficient, we know from previous, Q is equal to this, we know क्यू इज इक्वल टू टी ए माइनस टी बी डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ आर, समेशन ऑफ आर वी नो दिस इक्वेशन. द सेम इक्वेशन इफ वी राइट इन दिस, द सेम इक्वेशन इफ वी राइट लाइक दिस, इफ वी राइट लाइक दिस इंस्टेड हियर इट विल बी यू ए इज इक्वल टू वन डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ आर. इफ वी कंपेयर दिस टू इक्वेशन, दिस इक्वेशन आई विल हाईलाइट हियर, इफ वी कंपेयर दिस टू इक्वेशन, दिस इक्वेशन एंड दिस इक्वेशन, फ्रॉम दिस टू इक्वेशन वॉट वी कैन राइट इज यू ए इज इक्वल टू, दैट इज यू ए इज इक्वल टू यू ए इफ वी राइट इट इज इक्वल टू वन डिवाइडेड बाई समेशन ऑफ आर, वन डिवाइडेड बाय समेशन ऑफ आर, समेशन ऑफ आर वी इज इक्वल, कंपेयरिंग दीज टू इक्वेशंस यू कैन राइट यू वी इज इक्वल टू इक्वेशन, कंपेयरिंग इक्वेशन 4.21 एंड 4.16 वी कैन राइट यू वी इज इक्वल टू वन बाय समेशन ऑफ आर. हियर यू इज हियर यू कैन से यू ए डिवाइडेड बाय समेशन ऑफ आर आर टी एच. ओके हियर देयरफॉर यू इज इक्वल टू 1 divided by A into summation of R thermal. Here U is called as overall heat transfer coefficient. U can be calculated as 1 divided by A into summation of all thermal resistance. Okay. Here U can be calculated in different ways. That is, for us, A is the area. A is the area. But for a sphere and cylinder, you will be two types of U's will be there, that will discuss further, or I think it is better to take now only. For a cylinder and sphere, you will be U is the overall heat transfer. For a cylinder and sphere, we'll discuss. For a cylinder, again, for a cylinder, from basics, one-dimensional steady state equation will be this one. For a cylinder, one-dimensional steady state equation will be this one. For a cylinder, this is not three-dimensional steady state. If we reduce to one-dimensional steady state, this is the one-dimensional steady state equation for a cylinder in a cylindrical coordinate system. Then if we integrate this equation, if we integrate this equation, we'll get the algebraic equation. If we apply again same boundary conditions for a cylinder, if we apply the boundary conditions for a cylinder, that is, if it is a cylinder like this, of a inner radius r1 and outer radius r2, if inner radius is r1 and outer radius is R2, or here it is taken as R0 and RI. If inner radius is RI and outer radius is R0, okay, then this is inner radius, then we can at R is equal to RI, T is equal to TI, R is equal to, if we write the its boundary condition and if we solve, we'll get for a cylinder the equation Q is equal to 2 pi K L T1 minus T2 divided by ln of R2 bar. The same, this equation can also be again written in the form of electrical analogy. That is, Q is equal to, we can write this equation in the form of electrical analogy. That is, Q is equal to delta T divided by R cylindrical. For a cylinder, the thermal resistance will be this one. The thermal resistance will be ln of R2 by R0 by RI divided by 2 pi KL. Okay, here this is the thermal resistance, ln of R for a slab or in a Cartesian coordinates, thermal resistance is L by KA, but for a cylindrical coordinates, thermal resistance is equal to ln of R2 by R1 divided by 2 pi KL. Okay, for a composites cylinders, if there are two or three composite cylinder, again similar pattern. Q is equal to, if we take the temperatures here, if we take these two temperatures, क्यू इज इक्वल टू टी ए माइनस टी बी और टू टेक ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस हियर आर ए प्लस आर वन प्लस आर टू द सेम हैज बिन रिटन हियर क्यू इज इक्वल टू क्यू इज इक्वल टू टी ए माइनस टी बी डिवाइडेड बाई आर ए प्लस आर वन प्लस आर टू ओके दैट इज समेशन ऑफ आर आर ए इज नथिंग बट अगेन देर इज अ कन्वेक्शन इन द साइड द सिलेंडर हियर दिस इज अ कंपोजिट सिलेंडर इन साइड देर इज अ फ्लूइड इन साइड देर इज अ फ्लूइड देर इज कन्वेक्शन फ्रॉम द फ्लूइड टू द फर्स्ट लेयर there is conduction again there is conduction in the second layer again there is convection therefore resistance due to convection is ra it is 1 divided by ha resistance due to conduction is r1 it is ln of r2 outer radius minus divided by inner radius that is r2 by r1 divided by 2 pi kl r2 is ln of r3 by r2 divided by 2 pi kl the same thing I have written here separately for heat transfer from the inner fluid to the wall 1 of temperature T1 this is heat transfer from the inner fluid that is heat transfer from the fluid is there inside there is fluid inside heat transfer from the fluid to the wall of temperature T1 that is Q it is equal to convection heat transfer that is written here that is written q is equal to ha 2 pi r1 l into ta minus t1 in the similar way there is conduction heat transfer in the first layer of the cylinder that is given by 2 pi kl t1 minus t2 divided by ln of r2 by r1 if we add all this we will get this equation it is similar to that of the heat transfer in the Cartesian coordinate system if we take two temperatures if we calculate heat transfer remains same heat current remains same we have to take the thermal resistance between those two temperatures between those two temperatures okay here for a cylinder overall heat transfer coefficient that is wall ua is equal to 1 divided by summation of ra overall heat transfer coefficient UA is equal to summation of RA. This is what I want to. UA is equal to 1 divided by summation of R. But for a cylinder and sphere, there are two types of areas. Therefore, there are two types of overall heat transfer coefficient. That is UI, internal overall heat transfer coefficient based on internal area. That is UI is equal to 1 divided by AI summation of R and overall heat transfer coefficient based on the external this external area now what is and it is the overall heat transfer coefficient based on outside area it is 1 divided by a naught summation of r again summation of r the same thing 1 divided by ai into summation of r is nothing but ra plus r1 plus r2 plus rb here that is 1 divided by ui is equal to and ui is equal to if we simplify you will get like this this equation is in the heat transfer data here u naught is equal to 1 divided by a naught into summation of r a summation of r is nothing but ra 1 divided by h into a rb r sorry r2 r3 and rb for a sphere in the similar way if we analyze for a sphere we'll get if q is a heat transfer if q is a for a spherical coordinate system for a spherical coordinate system this is the equation for the heat transfer for a spherical coordinate system if we consider one dimensional steady state spherical coordinate equation this is the this equation is the temperature. This equation is the one dimensional spherical coordinates steady state equation in spherical coordinates. If we integrate and if we do the same thing as we have done for the slab as well as the cylinder, we'll get an algebraic equation. If we integrate and if we apply boundary condition, we'll get an algebraic equation. We'll get an equation like this. Heat transfer through the sphere Q is equal to 4 pi k r1 ri r0 ti minus t0 divided by r0 minus ri. Here ri is the internal radius of the sphere, r0 is the external radius of the sphere. Okay, here the same, this equation, whatever this equation is there, 4.54, we can write its electrical analogy, that is in the form of delta t divided by r. If we write like this, 4.54 in the form of delta t divided by r, resistance for a sphere, we will get it as r0 minus ri divided by 4 pi k r0 into ri. That is the resistance for the sphere, r0 minus ri. Here whatever I am highlighting this, that is the resistance for a sphere, resistance for a sphere. Again, for a sphere, composite spheres, we have to add the resistance. Add the resistance. This equation is the resistance. Okay, if we take composite sphere, if we take the temperatures here TA and the temperature here TB, if we are calculating what is the heat transfer Q, we have to write it as TA minus TB, TA minus TB divided by summation of R, divided by summation of R. Summation of R is nothing but here RA plus RB plus, sorry, plus R1 plus R2 plus RB. RA can be given as 1 divided by HA into, 1 divided by HA into A. HA is the internal, because there is a sphere, here there is a convection heat transfer, here also there is a convection heat transfer. Here in these two composite sphere, there is conduction heat transfer. The convection is the heat transfer is given by 1 divided by RA is equal to 1 divided by HA, H suffix A. That is convection heat transfer in the internal surface into A. Here A is the, A here RA is equal to, here A is the important thing, A is the area of the sphere, area, internal area of the sphere for a cylinder, internal area of the sphere for a cylinder, AI, I can write like that. In the similar way, R1, R1 can be given as using this equation, R1 is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by 4 pi k R1 into R2. In the similar way, R2 is equal to using this equation, R3 minus R2 divided by 4 pi k R2 into R3. Okay, here the same thing has been written here. Okay, here RA is equal to 1 divided by HI into R1 square. 4 pi we have taken, 4 pi R1 square it is, 4 pi it has been taken in the numerator at the top, therefore it is 1 divided by HA into R1 square. Actually it will be 1 divided by HA into area of the internal sphere, area of the internal sphere is equal to 4 pi R1 square, therefore it is taken at as 1 divided by HA into, this is RA and this term is RB. Okay, this is RB, this RB, this is R1 and R2, R1 and R2. Again, for a sphere also there will be two types of overall heat transfer coefficient based on the internal surface and the external surface. Okay, this is, in the next lecture video we'll discuss problems on heat transfer, problems on conduction heat transfer. Okay.